You want me dead. Say it.
No.
The hit fantasy horror drama Van Helsing has been around since 2016 and raked in a number of mixed reviews during its time on the air. While most would like to believe that it's simply because its time has come, the truth is much more complicated than they would have us believe. So what could it be? The Sci-Fi Network was even kind enough to let the show conclude rather than straight up cancel it like most shows in 2020, but we got the feeling there's more to it than what they're telling us. Here is the real reason Van Helsing ended. But before we get into the video, please don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to the channel with notifications on so you don't miss any of the new videos we post. First, the mixed ratings. The nature of the show draws in a unique audience. The gothic theme won't sit well for everyone, but nevertheless, it's been able to establish a solid following. On Rotten Tomatoes, Van Helsing Season 1 rated an 82% on the tomato meter, but only a 53% audience score. It's not rare for the audience and critics to disagree on a show, but usually it's the audience score that is more forgiving than the critics. The problem with the show is that it's got a great concept with a poor delivery. This can be because of the writers of the show, but I'll get to them later. While its unique audience loved the dark tone of the show, the average viewer wasn't as forgiving. The peak of the show was in its second and third season, but every season after that progressively got worse. By the time the final season came, both the audience and the cast were ready for it to end. Speaking of cast members, Kelly Overton was another big reason the show ended. Overton was at the forefront of the series, but even actors get drained of their own show. When the show announced its ending, Overton was a little too happy about the news, retweeting the news with a number of different emojis saying, "Let's do it." In an interview with Hollywood Soapbox, Overton stated that she was happy with the complete arc of the character. "It's a full story from beginning to ending, and Overton wanted to leave it that way. Can you blame her? Think about how many shows go past its welcome. We get a couple good seasons, feel satisfied with the ending, then the writers barf out another couple seasons for the money." Overton didn't want that. She was more than satisfied with her character arc and wanted to leave it at that. Plus, let's be honest, she was probably done with the role a long while ago. Third, let the vampires die. I'm sorry, vampire lovers, but the vampire craze ended with Twilight over a decade ago. In fact, the entire undead thing died with Glenn from The Walking Dead. With ratings getting lower and lower, the undead theme not being as popular as it used to be, it was hard for the show to get any traction. Long-running shows like Supernatural and The Vampire Diaries ended with the steady decline of their popularity. While Van Helsing wasn't quite the titan these other shows were, they fell victim to the shift of popularity as well. A show is only as successful as the number of viewers it gains, and the market for supernatural lovers has steadily decreased over time. With a dying audience and no new viewers in sight, the show was doomed to fall into TV obscurity. It's hard to justify a show with a progressively lowering audience, but hey, at least they were able to go out on their own terms. Next, let's talk about legacies. Kelly Overton is not the first Van Helsing heard of. The name is legendary amongst vampire hunters. The fictional character was written in 1897 for the novel Dracula, and since been adapted to a number of different films. I'm talking Dracula 1931, The Brides of Dracula 1960, Dracula 2000, Underworld 2003, Van Helsing 2004. There are over 27 movies that feature the vampire hunter, and I get it, Van Helsing is a household name, but at some point you're beating a dead horse. Do you really think that in 2021 the average person wants to invest their time in a character from the 1800s? Take the novel Moby Dick, for example, revered as the greatest novel in American history. By all means, a great book, but how well did its movie adaptations do? Do you guys even know what I'm talking about? I didn't think so. I'm talking about The Heart of the Sea with Chris Hemsworth and Tom Holland, two big-time actors with millions of fans in a movie that nobody knew existed. Did you really think that a reboot of a far less successful novel would make it in the long run? 5. Surprise, surprise, COVID-19 strikes again. I know I said that Van Helsing is one of the few shows that didn't get canceled because of COVID, but canceled is a technical term. Sure, it was able to neatly wrap up its series with a final season, but the show was filmed and produced in Vancouver, Washington, while the TV network Sci-Fi is based in York. With the borders closed, the production of the show took a complicated turn. While they were able to film the essentials before the shutdown, the show wasn't immune to the complications of COVID protocols. Communication between the network and the production became strained in 2020, just like everywhere else. It was difficult to do anything in 2020, so the show was lucky that Sci-Fi was gracious enough to let them wrap up production on their own terms. They may say that it was time to let the show end, but you can't say that it didn't have anything to do with 2020. Next, the writing. Jonathan Lloyd Walker and Neil LaBute. You'll find countless reviews on the show criticizing criticizing the poor plot. It's full of cliches and predictable plot lines. Part of the reason the show wasn't as successful as other supernatural shows was because of its poor writing. That's what happens when you base your story on a 100-year-old book. If you look at the resumes of both writers, you'll notice that this kind of story is new to the both of them. It's not exactly their forte. They write dramas, over-the-top action movies, and comedies. They had no place amongst the supernatural. Maybe they could have boosted their reviews by bringing in more writers to the fold, helping them avoid so many of the cliches that they tended to fall back on. 7. Netflix. Worry not, Van Helsing fans. You could still catch your favorite vampire slayer on Netflix. The show was picked up by the popular streaming service back 2019. The superpower that is Netflix will bring in far more popularity for the show than it ever could have on traditional television. This is both a blessing and a curse for fans. While the show won't completely disappear from the face of the earth, it won't need to keep going anymore. Profits it receives from Netflix is more than enough to satisfy the showrunners for years. Why would you worry about writing and advertising when the mega powerhouse will do it all for you? Unless it catches wildfire and becomes a series hit like The Queen's Gambit did, I don't see Netflix producing and continuing the show past its current state. For now, it sits as one of the many shows under a very large collection. 8. Money, money, money. The show itself has a fairly deep budget, but how much does that matter when you're spending more than you're making? This is what it all comes down to, right? Profit. The show's got some seriously good makeup artists and filmed in different parts of the world. That is not cheap, especially for a show with a limited audience. Sure, being on Netflix was its saving grace, but it wasn't enough to push them through to a season 6. This is not to say that the show was going bankrupt. I'd imagine that they'd make enough to pay for its cast and crew, as well as pay for the thousands of dollars of equipment. The thing is, there is a difference between paying your bills and truly profiting. Van Helsing? They're making enough to pay their bills. That's it. Finally, big surprise. It's just because the story is over. Like I said, the story has reached its full arc. Nobody wants to see any more forced episodes for the sake of profit. The CW's Arrow did this, and the once great show took a bad turn. The ratings of the show took a serious plunge in the end after trying to push the show past its prime. Van Helsing knew its time was over and accepted it. Its fans accepted it, the showrunners accepted it, and the actors accepted it. Let's all just accept the fact that the bad guys are dead and the good guys won. And the story's over. It would have been a disservice to the show's fans and the entire crew to continue on the way it did. I, for one, am glad it ended the way it did. Well, that's it for the video. Just a reminder to please like this video and subscribe to our channel. We want to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching. See you next time.